Yes, you are a donkey.
A Florida man attacked an ATM for a very strange reason. It gave him too much money. Florida man is arrested after deputies say he rigged the door to his home in an attempt to electrocute his pregnant wife. Police arrested an Orlando man for attacking a flamingo.
The Breakfast Club, bitches.
Donkey of the day with Charlemagne the God.
Let's
I don't
get
know why
to it.
Keep letting him get y'all like this.
Donkey of the day for Friday, January 31st goes to an 18-year-old Seminole County High School student named Jaquila Taylor. You know what Seminole County is, right? Florida! What does Uncle Charlotte always say about Florida? Huh? The craziest people in America come from the Bronx and all of Florida, and every day they prove me right. Earlier this week, I think even maybe yesterday, I gave another person from Seminole County Donkey of the Day, right? I don't even remember what for right now, because Florida's crazy. It's just all one big blur to me. But this young lady is 18 years old. Her name is Jaquila Taylor, like I just told you. She's known around the way as Kiki. Kiki, do you love me? Are you riding? No, this Kiki don't give a damn about you. She's not riding. She's robbing. All right? See, Kiki has been charged with robbery with a firearm and attempted murder. How did we get to this point? Where did this 18-year-old girl go wrong? Well, there's a dating app to blame, and that dating app is Plenty of Fish. Now, I was told that Plenty of Fish was a lesbian app. I was told that this is where lesbians go to find
what?
Fish.
No.
That's not true?
I don't Plenty think of Fish so. In the sea.
Okay. Oh, that's what that means. Okay. So I guess every gender goes on Plenty of Fish to just find fish. Now, I was asking around the room about Plenty of Fish. A lot of people in this room have Plenty of Fish accounts. I guess Plenty of Fish is big with the kids. Our producer, Dan, who used to have a Plenty of Fish account. When did you have your account, Dan?
This was like 2013, 2014.
Okay. And what was your experience?
So this is my experience.
What was your experience? Give me your Plenty of Fish
my
experience.
My personal
story.
Experience
Give
was...
me that fish!
All the girls that were reaching out to me were big girls.
Oh!
So, that was just my experience.
Wow. Nothing wrong with that.
Okay.
No, I didn't pursue anything.
So a lot of fat fish. A lot of fat fish was on there. Okay. Now, our other producer, Taylor. Taylor, you had a Plenty of Fish account. What happened?
My bad.
Oh, you cursed?
My Plenty of Fish...
Get to it, Taylor.
Come on, Taylor. We have a limited amount of time.
A lot of the guys were saying that there were a lot of big girls on there and that there were a lot of transgenders on there.
Oh, okay. A lot of trans fish. Nothing wrong with that. Now, Drom, you said you had a Plenty of Fish story,
goodness
too, right?
Goodness gracious.
Give me that fish.
It was one of my friends.
That was one of your friends.
Okay. What was one of your friends' experience, Drom?
One of my friends, he went to go pick up the girl that he met on Plenty of Fish, and when she walked out of the house... She was a little person.
What you mean, like a little person?
What you mean, a little person?
She was like,
you know what a little person.
You know, a little person.
Like a real little person. So, like, if I was to say the word, that'd be the politically incorrect way
like
to say it.
Like a legally little person, you know.
Got you.
Okay.
Got you. Okay, so it sounds like it's a lot of variety on Plenty of Fish. Interesting. Okay, well, this Florida fish, this fish that this young man caught in Seminole County named Kiki, he should have thrown that one back in the water. Okay, would you like to hear why? Let's go to WKMG CBS 6 for the report, please.
Matt, a man thought he was going on a date with a woman he met on the dating app Plenty of Fish, but police say that date lured him into a trap. Sanford police say 18-year-old Jaquila Taylor met up with a 31-year-old man she had met on the dating app Plenty of Fish. Officers say Taylor asked the victim to pick up food from McDonald's before meeting up with her on West 10th Street. That's when police say Taylor met her date and got in his car and told them to park in the back of the house.
When they met up, her behavior was a little bit suspicious. And then he was approached by two males who attempted to rob him, struck him with a firearm a couple of times. And as he ran from the area, he was struck by a bullet.
Sanford police say the man was shot in the chest and that his injuries were very serious. Police say Taylor was arrested by school resource officers from Seminole High School. And officers say they are still looking for the two males involved. After Taylor's representation argued that the arrest report didn't have enough information to charge her with attempted homicide, a judge gave police 24 hours to amend their report holding her without bond on the robbery with a firearm charge.
Now, so many things wrong with this story. The number one thing, setting up a person to get robbed, disgusting. All right. Secondly, having the person meet you at your grandmother's house, stupid. If you're going to commit a crime, why would you have them come to your residence or a residence you frequent often? Third, this 18-year-old woman is asking for McDonald's at 2 in the morning. It says right here, the teen asked the victim to bring her McDonald's, according to the arrest report. This is exactly why Dan and Taylor said it's a lot of fat women on Plenty of Fish, okay? Is this a thing on Plenty of Fish? Since you know it's chubby women on Plenty of Fish, you just offered them McDonald's to get them to hook up with you? Okay, I'm looking at the video. Kiki does look a little chubby from the video I've seen, so I'm sure this man saw her and just assumed she was hungry. But that is essentially what got him shot and robbed. And Kiki, it doesn't matter if you didn't know the man would be shot. Okay, you agreed to help set this man up. Doesn't matter if you didn't know the guys or not. Doesn't matter if you didn't know he was going to be shot. You knew something was going to happen to him because you agreed to set him up. Doesn't matter what the details of said setup were. And for that, I need Remy Ma to give Jaquila Taylor, a.k.a. Kiki, the biggest hee-haw.
Hee-haw, hee-haw, you stupid motherfucker, are you dumb?
I'm going to be honest with you. Stories like this just make me happy to be married. It's clearly difficult out here to date. I'm too old to be navigating apps and stuff, and if I did, I don't think I would be on Plenty of Fish.
Donkey of the Day is brought to you by the Law Office of Michael S. Lamonsoff. Don't be a donkey. Dial #250 on your cell and say the bull if you've been hurt in a construction accident. That's #250 from your cell and say the bull.